Hi everyone, welcome to the final episode of my Dorney Park recreation. So for the past few months, I've been working on building this recreation of Dorney Park. This is a real park in Allentown, Pennsylvania, a Cedar Fair park. And as of now, it is finally finished and ready for you to download if you would like to take a look at it for yourself. So you may be familiar with the series I did in 2022 on Cedar Point. That was a very long and very large build. Took a very long time to get that one done. And I thought it would be fun to do another recreation project, but I did want to do something a little bit smaller, a little bit more manageable. So having been on a trip to Dorney Park earlier this year, I thought it would make a pretty good candidate for another recreation project. The kinds of rides that are available in RCT and that we can make in OpenRCT2 resulted in a pretty good recreation, if I do say so myself. I think it turned out pretty nicely. So for this video, we're just going to do a final tour, show you all the little bits and pieces of the park, including some that you might not have seen in some of the previous episodes. Just kind of show off everything that I built, talk a little about some of the build process, some of the design decisions, things like that. So why don't we go ahead and get started? So we'll start here at the front of the park, where there are a front entrance here and our partial parking lot. Not a whole lot to do for peeps at the front entrance here. In my Cedar Point park, I added a ticket booth that they could line up for. Decided to keep it simpler up here so that there would be fewer problems with peep pathfinding as the park got bigger and bigger. One other thing that helped with that, actually, is that there are in fact four entrances to the park. There are three hidden ones on each side of the park that do help a lot for getting peeps around, making sure they can leave when they want to. We have fewer trapped guests that way, which is pretty handy. Especially with 6,000 or so guests in the park, it's very easy for just a couple lost guests to quickly tank the rating. Anyway, after the entrance, we have our main midway going towards the upper right of the screen. A couple little small rides in here, some shops and administrative buildings, things like that. Like our guest services here, our main antique carousel here in the middle. That is a simple shoestringing ride, which I think this one turned out really nicely. I'm really happy with the design for this one, especially with its smaller footprint compared to my Cedar Point version. It fits in the space very nicely and doesn't overwhelm the space around it. Anyway, some more shops, restaurants, food kiosks. Going back towards the back of the main midway, we've got our arcade area and our bumper cars. And back behind that, we get to our first coaster, Talon, the B&M Invert. If you're more interested in seeing the layouts of the coasters, there is a video I put up recently that compares each of my builds to the real-life POVs. So definitely check that out if you're interested. I'm not going to go over the roller coasters in too much detail. Each one has its own episode, of course, where I go over the builds in more detail as well. Heading back towards the back of the midway, we have our Wave Swinger. Very typical build for the Wave Swinger in OpenRCT2, but I think it looks pretty nice. You can tweak a little bit of the details on the Wave Swinger, like how the topper looks and what kind of cars you use, but I'm pretty happy with this build. I just wish they weren't all pink, because when you make them pink in RCT, they do stand out pretty significantly. Back behind this area, we have our river raft ride, Thunder Canyon, and our other water ride over here, the Splash Boats Whitewater Landing. I have to mess over because I can never remember the name. We turn around here. The midway continues in this direction. We've got some more shops and restaurants here, in addition to Wild Mouse, our second roller coaster. If you remember back from when we did our rough drafts and I built Wild Mouse in its own episode, I did stick with the weird wobbly chain lift to get it at a more 45 degree-ish angle, just for a more compact footprint. There are other options that you could do, like a stretched out steep lift could have worked, but I've seen other people build those and I think I don't like them quite as much. But that's just personal preference. Wild Mice coasters are very hard to decorate though, so this one was a real mess to do supports on, and I don't ever want to do one of those again. Continuing down our midway anyway, we've got Meteor here, a shoestring swinging ride. This one was a real beast to put together and get it working correctly. There's some real tricky hacks here using a multi-dimensional coaster to get two simultaneous loops going. So that one was fun to figure out, but not super fun to build and make sure it was all working correctly. But it's a pretty cool ride. I like the way it looks a lot. I like that we got the right kind of cars on it compared to the real ride. It's too bad that you can't have, you know, arms on it, but that's just the way RCT is. Back here we have Hydra, our B&M floorless coaster. Nothing too crazy going on with this one. There are a couple places where we are using some track merging to get some different inversions that the B&M track in OpenRCT2 currently doesn't support. The new pieces like the zero G rolls and medium half loops. Be nice if one day we can get those pieces in for the B&M track, but if not, whatever. The LIM and a single roller coaster spine works pretty well. Continuing on down our midway, we start getting into the part of the park where we have a lot of flat rides, like our Tilt-A-Whirl, our Music Express, Apollo, and the launch towers over here, Dominator. A lot of shoestring rides, but since they're all just rides that spin in a circle, all pretty easy to put together. Meteor was definitely the most complicated ride I had to shoestring here in this park, which is nice. I've gotten very good at remembering the steps for putting together this simple spin in a circle shoestring ride, so it's nice that the ones that we have here, that's all they did. So speaking of spinny rides, quick detour here, if we move over to the middle of the park, this is where we have Planet Snoopy, the kitty area. And the Cedar Fair kitty areas also have a lot of little rides that spin in a circle. Fortunately, a lot of these were possible to do without any shoestringing. They're basically just roller coasters in power launch mode that do several laps, so very easy to put together, and they fit in a nice little 3x3 footprint. Although even with the 3x3 footprint, they still take up a lot of space in RCT terms, so the kitty area is a lot bigger here than it is in real life, and it's laid out a little bit differently so I could squeeze everything in, especially the roller coaster here at Woodstock Express. It's quite large compared to the real thing, but in RCT you can only go so small with the junior coasters. But fortunately I was able to move everything around to accommodate for that, so that wasn't so bad. So if we keep going past that area, over here we have, I think, is a picnic area. I didn't go back here when I visited the park, but I think there's just a bunch of picnic pavilions. They're not always used during the operating year, as far as I know. And I believe one of them, this one here with the castle walls in the front, is a haunted house for haunt season. I'm not sure if it's even a picnic pavilion the rest of the year. So I did build this whole section off camera. There was no episode for it because a lot of it's not very exciting. These buildings are all pretty similar, but I think it did turn out pretty nice. Adds a little bit of extra charm to the part of the park. So moving on from here, a couple more little flat rides, like the classic whip ride over here. As I mentioned, I'm a big fan of how my whip turned out. I think the roofing on here has got a good shape. It's just fun to see the cars go around and everything, so pretty happy with that whip. And speaking of classic rides, we also have Zephyr over here, the train ride that goes on a tour of this half the park. As you can see, we're using the streamlined monorail trains for it instead of the typical steam train, and that's because that's what it looks like in real life. I think it's pretty cool that it worked out as well as it did. So back in this half the park, got some more of our major rides. We've got Demon Drop, the Intamin first generation freefall, one of the few left in the world, relocated from Cedar Point. These ones are fun to build and decorate. I have a tutorial on building these if you're curious to see how it works. A couple more big roller coasters back here as well. You can see a Thunderhawk, the classic Woody. This is the only coaster where I made a pretty significant layout change. The turnaround into the chain lift is reversed from real life because the chain lift is on like a 20 degree diagonal, which didn't work at all in RCT for the layout purposes. So it's a little bit simpler here in my build, but I think it works out just fine. You can see inside here we have a vanilla scrambler. Compared to a lot of the rides I built in Cedar Point, I did a lot of shoestringing for rides like this, and I wanted to keep the footprints of my rides in Dorney a little bit smaller to help them look a little bit more realistic. I think a lot of the rides in my Cedar Point park were a little bit too big for the scale of the game. So used a vanilla scrambler here, and I think it worked out really nicely, especially when you add some trim and fencing and bushes and things help make it a little bit bigger than it would be otherwise. I think it fills out the space really nicely. So back here past Thunderhawk's turnaround, we've got Steel Force, our Morgan hypercoaster. Nothing too crazy about this one, just a lot of wild custom supports to get that Morgan Arrow look, which thank goodness for the Scenery Manager plugin again, makes building things like this so much easier. So very grateful for that. So way back here at the back of the park, our last couple roller coasters, you can see Iron Menace. This is the new for 2024 roller coaster. As of this recording, it is still under construction. I believe they've got pieces in the park right now. I don't think any of them are put together. I haven't seen an update in a while, so I really have no idea how far along it is, but it's slated to open in 2024. Dorney Park released a really nice POV and some really good animated fly around video that helped me get a really good sense of what the layout is for this ride. It's not super simple to do in RCT because of some of the weird angles, as usual, but considering what we have to work with, I think my layout turned out pretty okay. So coming up back this midway, we've got Possessed, the Intamin Impulse Coaster, and that takes us back to Monster and the flat rides we were at before. This is another example of what I'm talking about with condensing the footprint of some of my flat rides. I built another Monster for Cedar Point. It's this exact same model of ride. This one here is, I think, 5x5 tiles, but the one in Cedar Point is like 8x8 or 9x9 or something enormous, and it looks way too big, so I really like the more compact version here, even though it doesn't have the right number of arms or cars. Like, I think making it smaller and fitting in the layout of the park was a lot better than making it more realistic. So I tried to strike that balance in this park, having things look nicer and fit together better than having them be ultra realistic. It's a pretty tough balance to strike when you're doing recreations, so just part of the puzzle of playing in RCT. But that about wraps up for the main park. If you've been to this park, you might have seen that the layout of the park is a bit strange because the main midway starts over here at the entrance and does this big like U-shaped curve around, which is pretty strange. So I thought we'd have a lot of issues with guests getting lost because of that, but fortunately there's enough shortcuts and extra paths connecting everything together that we really haven't had any pathfinding issues at all. There's no underground path in this build, which is awesome. I had to put a lot of underground path in my Cedar Point build in order to keep people from getting lost all the time. So that was super frustrating trying to get people where they wanted to go. Haven't had to deal with any of that here, which is pretty nice. All these little extra bypasses and everything throughout the park have kept things pretty smooth. We've just had a couple issues with proxy pathing, especially near the front entrance. Weird fleeks with the game, not sure how some of that happened, but regardless, been pretty happy with the way that stuff has all worked, so. So aside from the main park, we also have the water park, Wildwater Kingdom. I dedicated several episodes of the series to this part of the park already, so if you've already seen those, there's really nothing new here to go over. You're already probably pretty familiar with it, but if you haven't seen those, so the water parks in RCT, very tricky to build because RCT was not designed for building water parks, but you can still get pretty close with some ride hacking, and you can approximate a lot of water park related rides with RCT. For example, Lazy River's here. You just have some invisible car ride basically, and you change the cars into dinghy boats, and then you've got a Lazy River. So we got two of those in here, one up here at the front and one back here at the back. Obviously the main attractions here, a lot of water slides made out of dinghy slide track. A little bit too big in scale for the game, so these are really hard to get pieced in where they need to go. You can see there's a lot of places where the tracks intersect with themselves, and that's just the way it is because dinghy slides are missing a lot of important pieces that we would need to make more compact layouts, like tiny turns or helixes, things like that. So we make do with what we can. Fortunately, I was able to fit in all the slides. I'm pretty sure I'm not missing any of them as far as I can remember. Most of them are not functional, but there are some that are. You can see Peeps getting on a few of them over here, and there's some speed slides over here as well. So that was pretty exciting to get those wired up and working. Helps make this part of the park look a little bit more lively, which I do like a lot. Otherwise, this park would be pretty dead if there was nothing to ride back here, and you'd probably just have people getting lost everywhere all the time. But fortunately, we don't have that problem, which is pretty nice. And then finally, there's a couple wave pools as well, and just like in Cedar Point, we're using some bumper boat rides to simulate people hanging out in the wave pools, which I think is a cute little addition. It doesn't really look too terribly realistic, but it gives them something to do. So again, nice to keep Peeps busy in the water park. But that about does it for the tour. Compared to Cedar Point, like I said, this is a much smaller park. It was much more manageable. I was able to do this in a lot less time. I think this whole build took me about 80 hours, I wanna say, compared to Cedar Point, which took probably 200. So it was definitely much nicer to do a smaller park, even though it's still quite big as far as RCT goes, compared to a lot of parks that I've seen people do. If you want to do recreations, that's just the way things go. Most parks are going to be pretty big compared to what you see for, you know, your typical RCT scenario park or whatever. So yeah, that's about it for the series. I want to say thanks to everybody who helped out with getting this to the finish line. I sent it out to some people for some last minute beta testing to help me with some issues, and that was really helpful to getting these last few bits built out. Thanks to people in the YouTube comments, I've gotten a lot of great feedback from people on YouTube for different ideas for ways I could build things, which has also been nice. It's great to get some immediate feedback as I post the videos, as I build. And of course, thanks to the development team who makes the game. Now, OpenRCT2 is awesome. You can do so many cool things with it. And I'm really glad I was able to have that help me build all these recreation parks. In addition to having all the plugins, so the plugin developers have put together some amazing tools that also help make parks like this easier to build as well. So if you'd like to download this park for yourself, there should be a link in the description of this video for a download. So this park doesn't use any custom objects. This is totally non-custom scenery, but it does use a lot of new features in the game. So at the time this video goes up, the release version of OpenRCT2 will not be able to load this park. You'll need to get the latest develop version of the game. In the future, the release version eventually will be able to load this, but as of right now, you'll need to be on develop. So yeah, that's about it for me. So I hope you enjoyed the series and have fun looking at the park. Thanks for watching.